Artist Paintbrushes, the ultimate guide. Your paintbrush should feel like an extension of your arm. But, all the different kinds of artist brushes which are available can sometimes only add confusion to the painting process, rather than making it easier. In this post, I discuss the different kinds of artist paint brushes which are available for you to use. Paint brush bristles. Artist brushes come with many different types of bristles. The bristles will generally determine what medium a brush is suitable for. For example, oil painting requires bristles which are resilient and have a nice spring. Acrylic paint is not as harsh, so you can use bristles which are a bit finer. Watercolor painting requires soft bristles which can hold lots of water. Bristles for artist brushes come in two forms, synthetic and animal. Animal hair brushes tend to be more expensive, but they can hold and apply paint in a way which is not possible with synthetic brushes. However, synthetic brushes have come a long way. I make use of both synthetic and animal hair brushes for my paintings. Here is a summary of the different bristles. Synthetic, economical and versatile options for all painting mediums. Most synthetic brush manufacturers will combine synthetic bristles with animal bristles, so you get the best of both worlds. I would avoid cheap synthetic brushes as they are not durable and lose shape quickly. Hog, stiff, springy and economical. Hog hair brushes tend to do most of the heavy lifting in oil painting due to their durability and stiffness. I enjoy using hog hair brushes for general oil painting work, but not so much for the finer details. Sable, not actually made from sable hair, but rather from the tail of a species of mink, a member of the weasel family, found in northeastern China and Siberia. Sable brushes are extremely fine, springy and hold lots of water, making them perfect for watercolor painting and fine oil, acrylic painting. Squirrel, very soft hair with little snap due to a lack of resistance. Squirrel hair is suitable for watercolor painting, inking and any other low resistance mediums. Badger, a popular hair for oil painting. Badger hair brushes tend to be the thickest at the tip of the brush and thinner around the belly, making them perfect for general and broad brushwork. Mongoose, sturdy and resilient hair which is used in oil and acrylic painting. Paint brush shapes. Filbert brushes are a personal favorite due to their versatility. They are somewhere between a round and flat brush. The curved tip allows for soft brushwork and blending. I use the filbert brush for any general brushwork. Round brushes have a large belly and a long tapered end. They are extremely versatile and can be used for long, bold strokes and detail work. A round brush made with sable hair comes to a very fine tip and can be used for delicate brushwork. Flat brushes have a flat tip and can be used to make thick, consistent strokes or thin lines. Flat brushes are great for blocking in solid shapes of color, i.e. roads, fences, buildings, etc. Bright brushes are pretty much a flat brush with shorter bristles. They are useful for short, controlled strokes. Fan brushes are more of a specialty brush. They have a range of special uses, such as painting the leaves on trees or adding texture to grass or rocks. But the fan brush is not limited to these special occasions. You can make use of the fan brush whenever you need scattered and broad brushwork. Angular brushes have bristles which are cut at a slight angle, with one side of the tip longer than the other. I do not use these brushes, so I will not comment on how you can use them. Paint brush sizes. There is no industry standard for brush sizes, so it is best to get familiar with one brand. It is important to have a range of small, medium and large brushes. In particular, you should make sure you have lots of medium to large brushes as these should be doing most of the heavy lifting in your paintings. I generally recommended that you take the largest brush you feel comfortable with using, then use one size up from that. The benefits of using large brushes include. Large brushes will ensure you focus on making economical and meaningful strokes. Every stroke will have influence with a large brush. By using only small brushes, you tend to get caught up in needless details and miss the overall statement of your painting. Large brushes are a great time saver, as you can quickly cover the canvas. Even in the most intricate looking paintings, you will find that the brushes used were probably not these tiny round brushes. Take a look at the beautiful painting below by John Singer Sargent. Under that I provide a close-up which shows his broad and surprisingly thick strokes of color made with what I assume to be medium-sized brushes. What you should learn from this is, instead of trying to make your painting seem realistic up close, aim to make it seem realistic from afar. Which artist paint brush should you use? Personally, I use paint brushes as follows. For staining the canvas, I use the largest flat or filbert brush I have. For sketching the composition, I use a medium-sized round brush, or sometimes even a fan brush if I want a very rough landscape sketch. For blocking in general colors and shapes, I use a medium to large filbert. Sometimes I will use a flat brush if the shapes are very angular. For adding detail, I use smaller filbert and round brushes. I also use the fan brush in certain situations, such as for painting leaves, grass or water. For signing the painting and adding very fine details, I use a small round brush. Which brand of artist paint brush should you use? I have had experience with brushes from most of the top brands such as Princeton, Winsor & Newton, Royal Langnickel and Old Holland. Most of these brands have a premium line of brushes which seem to be fairly consistent in quality. It really comes down to personal preference. I have heard some great things about Rosemary & Co., but I have yet to try those brushes out. I will place an order for some of those brushes soon and will let you know how I go. Paint brush sets. If you are just starting out in painting or you just want some extra brushes, you may want to look into buying a brush set. These will give you a wide range of brushes which you can get a feel for. However, I have found the quality of many popular brush sets to be on the lower end. For very high quality brushes, you will usually need to purchase them individually. But there are premium brush sets like below if you want to treat yourself. Paint brush storage. It is important that you keep all your brushes organized to some extent. Otherwise, they will probably go missing or get damaged. I suggest you invest in a simple brush container, or you could even just use an old mug. Caring for your paint brushes. Taking proper care of your brushes is essential if you want them to last for more than just a few painting sessions. Just remember that prevention of brush damage is much easier than the restoration of it. Thank you for feeling our sharing. You can make a picture for yourself as a souvenir, for your friends, relatives. Or now, if you want to make a surprise gift for your dearest ones. You can give this great job to us. Please send us your most favorite photo and we will choose the best artists to convert into a work of art by hand painting. Your loved one will certainly be very happy to have this meaningful gift. Right now, click on the link below the description. And enjoy! If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe for more or share to help more people. Thank you so much. I attached link below description. Access now and follow it. Thank you.